Hello everyone, how is it going on? I'm back again with a new tutorial. In this tutorial, I'm gonna show how to create a contact form and then send email using PHP script from your localhost. So you don't need to upload the form in a live server. You can do it using localhost. You just need XAMPP or any other software that provide a PHP server. First of all, let's have a quick look at the demo of the project that we are going to do. Before that, please subscribe to my channel if you are new to the channel so that you can get all the updates. This is the form. As you see here, I am using localhost and I am using XAMPP software. So let's put some information here. So it can take a few seconds. Yeah, email sent. Now let's check the Gmail inbox. We should have a new email here. Yes, we see a new email with test subject. So that is what we're going to do. Without further ado, let's get started. Let's create the folder first. I'm assuming you are using XAMPP server. So we'll have to create the folder inside the htdocs. Let's do it. So it is located inside the C drive. And then XAMPP and then htdocs. Here let's create a new projects and let's name it contact form. We'll open it using the VS code. You can use any other code editor if you want, whatever you have. And here let's create the HTML file first, where we'll put the form. Here let's put some boilerplate code using the shortcut and let's change the title to contact form. And inside the body let's put a container div. And here we'll put the form with the method post, because we'll send the post method to the server. And here in the action we'll have to put a PHP file. Let's name it process.php. We'll have to create this file later. Now let's put the fields one by one. The first field will be the name. So it will be a text field. Input text. Here the name attribute can be name or full name. And let's put a placeholder here. Full name. Then let's copy it 3 times. The second one will be email. So here the name will attribute will be in email and the placeholder will be email or enter email. And here instead of text it will be email. And the third field will be also a text field, but it will be subject of the of the email. So here the placeholder enter subject. Now the fourth field will be a text area, because it is the message that will be sent to the email. So here the name can be message and the placeholder enter message. Alright, now we'll have to put the submit button. So input submit. Here the value can be sent. And let's put a name, submit. All right. Okay, now the HTML file is ready, but it will look very ugly if you check it in the browser. So we'll have to use some CSS. Because it is a PHP project, I will not use much CSS. So instead I will use the Bootstrap. So let's grab the Bootstrap CDN. Write bootstrapcdn.com in the browser. And let's copy the CSS part. We'll just need the HTML code. And let's put it inside the head tag. Alright, so we have the Bootstrap. Now we can use the predefined classes of Bootstrap. For the field, input field, we can use the class. We can use the class name form control. And we'll use some margin top 4. Margin top 4. So let's copy this class for other fields. Here instead of form control we'll have to use a different class button primary, because it is a button Now we can check it how it looks so far in the browser. So localhost, then contact form. Actually, we'll have to extract the XAMPP control panel. I forgot to do that. So the Apache server need to be started. All right, it's looking good. Now the HTML code or the form is ready. We'll have to send the data that will be put here to the email address. So let's go to the process.php. Actually, we'll have to create the process.php first. Process.php. So here you'll use the PHP tag first. As you know, whenever we'll write PHP code, we'll have to start the PHP tag. So here we'll grab the data first, but before that we'll have to check whether or not the form is submitted. So we can do that using a global array variable called server. Inside the server, the array will be request method. So if the request method is post, so if the form is submitted, we'll grab the data. So for example, the first data will be the name. So we can grab the data using the post array variable. Here the array key will be full name, as the name attribute was full name for the name, as you see here. And let's copy this 4 times. So the second field is email. Third field is subject. And the fourth field is message. Let's quickly have a look for the confirmation. So message, subject, all good. Now we can send the data using the mail function. It's a PHP function. Here the first argument is the recipient, so to where the email will be sent. The second field is the subject. Third field is the message itself, and the fourth field is the headers. Headers are basically the information about the senders. Now we can put this information into some variables. So for the to, I'll put my email address here. You can put your own email address so that you can check. And then subject. So we already have subject here. So also we have message here. We just need the header. So let's create another variable, header. And here we will just show the form email, form, and the email variable. All right, now let's change these two variables to subject, message, and headers. It will be actually headers. Okay, now we'll put this mail function inside the if statement so that we can check whether or not the email is delivered successfully. So if mail function work correctly, we'll display a message saying email sent. Otherwise, else echo email sending failed. Let's check the output in the browser. So let's put the information, the test information here. Sent. And here we see a warning, also email sending failed. That is because we have not, it was expected, I expected this warning because I have not configured the XAMPP on the php.ini file and the mail sendmail.ini file. So we'll have to make some changes on those two files. Let's locate those two files. The first one is php.ini, which is located inside the PHP folder. Here the file is php.ini. There is the file. So let's open it using Notepad and let's search for mail function. Here we'll have to change few things. First one is XAMPP and XAMPP port, send mail form, send mail path. These four things need to be changed in this file. I have saved the information in a text file here. So we can copy from here. So first one, smtp.gmail.com. So we are using Gmail as our SMTP provider. So here in SMTP, it will be smtp.gmail.com and the port will be 587. And let's remove the semicolon from sendmail from. Here we'll have to put our email address from where the email will be sent. So my email address in this case is, so I created this email address for testing purpose. Let's put here. So you'll have to put your own email address here. And here let's remove the semicolon from sendmail path. And let's copy the path from here. So if you use Windows and if you installed XAMPP in the C drive, the path will be look like this. If you install XAMPP in another folder, in that case you will have to change the name of the drive. So let's copy the path here. Okay, php.ini file changes are done. Now we'll have to change the sendmail.ini file, which is located inside the sendmail folder. Here we have sendmail.ini. Let's open it. And here we'll have to change again the SMTP server, then SMTP port, and then username, authentication username and authentication password. These four things we'll have to change. So let's again copy from here. So smtp.gmail.com is the SMTP server. Port is 587. Then we have here authentication username, which is the email address that you used in the php.ini file. So let's copy the email address from there. And then the password. For this password, we'll have to create a application password from our Google account. So let's go to the Google account. Click on here on your profile. Then you should see manage your Google account. Let's click on here. And then click on the security. And then click on the two-step verification. If you have already not added two-step verification, please add it before doing this. So let's click on two-step verification. Here I'll have to put my password. Now click next. So here you should see an option called a password at the bottom of the page. Let's click here and click app name. So in this case, I already have a app password named SMTP. Let's name it SMTP2 and click create. So you should see a password like this. Just copy the password, click done and put this password in the authentication password and click save. Now let's check the form again. Okay, we'll have to do another thing. We'll have to restart the server. So click stop and then click start. Now if you check, you still see email sending failed. I must have done something wrong in the code. Let's check the code. Yes, in the headers, instead of from, it is form. So let's fix it. It should be from. And also, let's put a colon. And let's save it. And let's check again in the browser. Now it should work fine. Yes, email sent. Let's check the Gmail inbox. There you go. You see a new email here. So that means everything is working fine. Let me know in the comments if you have any questions in your mind. Also, if you enjoy the tutorial, please hit like and please don't forget to subscribe. Thank you.